Cheryl Fountain, and I've been living in Yellowknife for 8 years, and I consider this my home. I love the Northwest Territories, the most beautiful country we have in Canada, in my opinion. So I know we have a lot of support from the Frame Lake, so I'd like to direct my question to Range Lake and the downtown core. My question is, given the fact that 1,100 people are teetering on the edge of homelessness, and these people are worth $25 million of annual transfer payments in the GNWT, what are you going to do to ensure the Northlands water and sewer infrastructure situation gets replaced as soon as possible? Or rather, the infrastructure itself gets replaced as soon as possible.
All right, shall we start with our candidates then from Range Lake? We'll begin this time with Dave. What's helped you?
Thank you very much for the question. I mean, the Northlands situation, as far as infrastructure goes, is terrible. And it's ridiculous that it's been allowed to get to the point that it's at. The GNWT should already have been loaning expertise, at the very least, on trying to get funding and trying to work with it. I mean, the GNWT has a number of folks that are excellent at getting federal funding and applying and knowing where to turn, whereas presumably the Condo Corporation doesn't have some of that same knowledge. It should be a real priority. I know the city's moving ahead with solutions, and the GNWT needs to be there to backstop them and support it. While it is a municipal issue, it's a very important one. I mean, just as you said, 1,100 residents, it's a lot of, frankly, annual money for the GNWT. The GNWT, I think, although has to have has a role as a supporter and leading it and giving the city advice on how to handle it and working with them. I know there's some ideas that come up about no-interest loans and things like that, which could be interesting to explore. But there does have to be a barrier where the GNWT needs to sort of watch how it's sort of working with each city and each community and each condo corp has its problems. But it is something that needs to get addressed as cost-effectively and as soon as possible. It can't be allowed to continue.
All right, thank you. Norm Smith of Range Lake.
Thank you. I've lived here for 33 years, and I remember living in Northlands when I first come to Yellowknife, so it was a really nice place back then, and the water ran and the toilets flushed. But I know you're having lots of problems now, and this government should certainly be supporting, you know, however we can to get that fixed. You have a major leak there, especially sewage leaks, can lead to all kinds of problems. Sewage is not a good thing to have to deal with, and the cost of cleanup would be probably more than the cost to fix the situation at this point. So, like my friend beside me here, David, he mentioned that Wendy and Duff had some input on how they would do that with interest loans and or free interest loans, and I think that's a good start. But
thank you, Pete McKenzie of Range Lake.
As I mentioned Monday night, for the poverty, Northland could approach from under the Charter Freedom, Section 7 of 15, to the federal government. The Canadian federal government is one of the few developed countries from the OECD that has a surplus. The CMHC has a surplus of about $6 to $7 billion a year. So they're, as from an MLA position in the government here, we can lobby those departments to assist you, to assist the city in solving that problem. Now, can we do it right away? You have to come up with a plan, a time limit, and then a strategy for that. If you want a copy of that, I can give it to you, because the United Nations has challenged Canada, which they were supposed to report in this past June, to address the accommodations for adequate housing for low-cost people.
And that's time. Thank you. And our final candidate in Range Lake is Daryl Delaney.
Great. Thanks, Cheryl, for your question. I'll answer it as long as you let me know that sewer girl is not going to go back and forth all night, because I'm getting seasick. Okay. Okay, thank you. It's a travesty that Northlands, again, and how many years later, we're talking about the same thing over and over again. And I assisted in the last election. I actually went every door in Frame Lake, and I saw firsthand a lot of situations. Really, not to duplicate what was mentioned here, there's lots of options. And but before the options, it's nice to see that the city has recently showed some interest in us, and I think that's a good sign. They're a stakeholder, and that's the first time I've seen that, so congratulations to the city for finally coming to the table. I know the owners themselves are involved, and they're a lot more motivated this time than I've seen before. So again, we've got to look at infrastructure options, we've got to look at all those models, and I know that if elected, I'll definitely be supporting this coming forward. Thank you.
All right, thank you. And our candidates from Yellowknife Center, beginning with Arlene Hushett.
The Northlands has already come up with a lot of different options that obviously I would support. I think the frustrating thing is this has been around for a long time, and the GNWT tends to take the position that you don't fit a program. So they never look at something like, you know, to solve a problem. They always want to try to fit the program into whatever the problem is, and it doesn't fit. So what I'd like to do is work on looking at the situation in Northlands as a challenge that needs to be solved and making sure that that's solved. And that would be through a partnership with the feds, the GNWT, the city, and the residents. But they already have identified great solutions. So it's just not happening, and I suspect it's GNWT policy that prevents that from moving forward.
Thank you. Yellowknife Center candidate, Robert Coffin.
Thank you, Jocelyn, and thank you, Cheryl, for the question. Quite frankly, I think talk has to come to an end on this particular subject because of, let's put it out there, I mean, health and safety is going to be a significant issue. And if anything, then we consider the 259 households, those households will be in serious jeopardy. Does the territorial government have a plan? Absolutely not, that I'm aware of. I've raised this issue and talked about how the impact on this, our city, the taxes, if we lose the money, if people leave. I mean, the fact is people can't walk away from their infrastructure, and I've seen it, a problem, people try to sell their house, they can't, they're being held hostage because there's no solution right now. The fact is there is a solution. Our federal housing folks do have money. I don't think the GNWT has spent enough time investing in that solution by getting them to come to the table. I think the territorial government is responsible to a certain percentage, but I mean, it is private property too. So there has to be the City of Yellowknife, GNWT, and working with CMHC to get the money, but they have to get out of the bumps. Thank you.
All right, thank you. And thank you, Cheryl, for your question.